The stereo EEG, both it's less invasive, but it also gives better information than the other techniques that we had. With the stereo EEG, we use tiny wire electrodes and place those anywhere in the brain that we need to, including areas that are very far away from the scalp. We usually put in about 250 electrode contacts. That's usually in about anywhere from 10 to 20 wires. And those allow us to see so much more of where the seizures are coming from. We can see so much more of the brain. It's really remarkable in the stereo EEG how well you can see exactly when and where the seizures start. And we're often surprised that the seizures will start in one very focal part of the brain and sort of stay there for several seconds before they actually spread to a seizure that is recognizable. The ROSA robot is a technology that we've had at Children's for about a year and a half now. And this is a better way to do stereo EEG. It's a robotic arm that very precisely localizes where we want to put in the electrode. The robot can get to those trajectories faster, can work with the technology to get the electrodes implanted more accurately and more quickly than with any other technology out there. Once we have all the information we need from the stereo EEG, it's a short procedure to remove the electrodes, and the patient's ready to go home the day after those electrodes are removed. Once they're removed, we have lots of time to go through all the data and make a good plan for the next step of that will hopefully cure the seizures. Most of our patients are able to then go on and have a surgical resection. So at Children's, since we've been doing the stereo EEG, we've seen a number of patients who probably would not have been candidates for surgery without that procedure. Where we just couldn't clearly localize the seizures or couldn't clearly define the borders of where the seizures were coming from until we did the stereo EEG. And so that's both made our surgeries more successful and more precise, but it's also expanded the number of patients that we can treat. We found some patients that wouldn't be a candidate for any other type of surgery until we were able to do the stereo EEG and learn more about their seizures from that.